Dr. Song, ladies and gentlemen, my dear colleagues, allow me first to express my sincere thanks to the organizing committee for allowing me to speak in this important scientific event. So, you probably will see that the title of the presentation is a little bit changed, but it doesn't matter because the content is still the same. It's just because of the little bit miscommunication between me and the organizer. Okay. Okay. Let me start by introducing Indonesia a little bit to you. Indonesia is actually an archipelago with 7,000 islands totally. And our total population now is more than 200 million, and the income per capita is slightly more than $3,000. The more exact figure is now 242 million. And there are, at the present time, we have 69 medical schools, and 53 of them have been already accredited. Now, we have about 15 large hospitals and which is actively involved in clinical trials. Later on, I will come back to this issue a little bit about giving you more information about the hospital. And this year, we have about 80,000 general practitioners plus 20,000 specialists throughout the country. Now, we all understand that today it is very important for us to work together, all nations in the world, to work hand by hand in the same objective to develop a new drug and to speed up the process. And the implementation of clinical research in Indonesia and also in other countries in Asia, I think, will give us a potential advantages such as we already know that potentially lower trial costs, less strict regulations, wide variety of diseases, and faster subject recruitment. Now the question is, what can we do now to accelerate the activity of clinical trials in Indonesia? And then, the present discussion is, of course, aimed in answering these questions. This is a little bit the map of Indonesia, and you can see here that there are dots here, yeah, showing that the center of the Indonesia is actually located in Jawa Island, and we have one city here in Medan where the active clinical trial takes place, and also in Jakarta, also Bandung, and many other places. And even though you look at the Papua, at the Papua, you don't see any doubt here, but there are many trials involving the development of drugs for the treatment or for the prophylaxis of malaria, for example. And there is another place here, in the a place near Bali, where the incidence of the hepatitis B is quite high, and there is a place there that the research involving the development of vaccines also takes place. Ladies and gentlemen, this is some figure showing you the activity of pre-marketing clinical trials in Indonesia from 2005 to 2010. And you can see here that the clinical trial phase 3 dominates the whole activity of the pre-marketing clinical trials. Okay, a little bit, let me continue with describing the outline, the hospitals, GCP, the ethics committee, CRO and insurance, the National Health Research Ethics Commission, and also the local regulation at the last. Ladies and gentlemen, a little bit about hospitals in Indonesia. We in Indonesia have more than 1,700 hospital from all size, the small and the big one, throughout the country. And you can see here that the large hospital, usually owned by the Department of Health, is only 34, and the province and district is more than 500 here. And almost 50% of these hospitals are already accredited by the, we call it in Bahasa Indonesia, is CARS, yeah, which is Hospital Accreditation Committee. Now a little bit about GCP. We know that GCP is very important for us to carry out high quality clinical trials. And Indonesia has formally adopted the ICH GCP in the year of 2001. And then immediately after the adoption process, the Indonesian FDA issued several regulations, and I will come back to this issue later on. And currently, it is estimated that there are about 1,200 investigators holding the GCP certificates throughout the countries. And we start from nothing. And the regular GCP trainings are now conducted by organizations like the National Health Research Ethics Committee. We abbreviate it to KNEPK in Indonesian language. This is activity carried out by the government. ISMED is an independent organization, and the CSU is a CRO in the institution where I work, that is the School of Medicine, University of Indonesia. Now, and in all training, we give a certificate after the participant passed the final examinations. And like usually occur in everywhere in the world, industries also help us to arrange this kind of GCP training, but they did not give any examination. Now the Ethics Committee. In 1982, the first ethics committee in the country was established, that is also in my institution, the School of Medicine, University of Indonesia. In 2003, the Minister of Health established the KNEPK, and the task is to improve the capability of the ethics committee throughout the countries. And today, the ethics committee exists in the most of the medical school and hospital which are carrying out clinical research. Some of the hospital is not affiliated with the medical faculty. Now, throughout the country we have 39 ethics committee until this year, and since 2010 ethics committee has been recognized. We have two ethics committee out of the 39 which has been recognized by the FERCAPS, and four other ethics committee are being in process. So what we need to improve in terms of the ethics committee? The first is, I think, the SOP-based operation systems, because in large city, well, the well-established ethics committee, they work quite well, but certain small ethics committee in the peripheral area outside of Java, some of them are still working without a definite or a clear SOP. The second one is independency, freedom of conflict of interest, continuous monitoring of subject safety, because many of these ethics committee are working in affiliation with the hospital, so the hospital also required a kind of assurance that if their patients are used as subject in the clinical trial, they also will require a kind of assurance that the subject is sufficiently protected. Also, GCCP standard and accreditation. Now, a little bit about contract research organizations and insurance in Indonesia. So these are all the factors we will require in conducting good quality clinical trials. The CROs are a great help, of course, for everybody who wants to carry out clinical trials, especially in countries like Indonesia or developing or other developing countries. For your information, we have a sufficient amount, a sufficient number of CRO now operating in Indonesia, including the, this is by alphabetical order, CSU, Equilab, Paraxel, Prodia, the CRO, Quintiles, and some others. And one of the largest CRO now is in from Indonesia is Prodia, and Prodia is already affiliated with its own lab, Prodia Lab, and also collaborates now with Quintiles since last year. Now, the other labs with ISO 15189 is not only Prodia, but Pramita, Parahita, and some others. And as long as I know, today there is only one insurance company who will provide protection for the research subjects. The name is ACE INA. This is an international insurance company. What else? KNEPK is the National Health Research Ethics Committee, and this KNEPK was established by the Ministry of Health in 2003, and the aim of the KNEPK, the objective is to nurture and improve the quality of ethics committees throughout Indonesia. And it routinely conducts training throughout the country for GCP and also for the ethics principles in for research using human subjects. And in the future, we hope that this KNEPK will move further to improve the quality of the ethics committees throughout the country by doing accreditation for the ethics committee in Indonesia. Now a little bit about the local regulations with regards to clinical trials. The Indonesian government requires that all pre-marketing clinical trials, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, and also all studies in bioavailability to bioequivalent, BABE studies, should apply for an approval from the regulatory authority prior to the implementation. So, in this case, GCP is mandatory. Clinical trials phase 4, or the post-marketing surveillance in Indonesia, this is not regarded as clinical trial. So in Indonesia, formally, if we conduct a post-marketing surveillance or phase 4 trial, you will not require an approval from the government. What you have to do is only give a notification in. And if in 10 working days you get no response from the government, that means you can start your study. For the pre-marketing trials in Indonesia, you don't have to wait for too long a time. 30 working days is usually applied for waiting, okay? And then clinical trials for educational purpose, I mean for the residents, for example, they are not required to adopt the GCP standard, but they have to work in accordance to the Declaration of Helsinki, and a notification is required by the government. Now, there are also other regulations that in Indonesia, research protocol should be reviewed not only from the ethical angles, but also from the scientific angle. If an institution does not have the scientific committee, then the burden to evaluate the scientific aspects is shifted to the ethics committee. So quite often in Indonesia, the ethical aspect as well as the scientific aspects are evaluated or reviewed by the ethics committee. And then finally, in the year of 2009, the Ministry of Health in Indonesia prohibits sending of all biological materials to any foreign country, except if there are tests which cannot be done at home, I mean in Indonesia. And this will of course take also time, and I think this is a kind of challenge we have to settle in the future. And for this, sending material to foreign country, you need a written permission from the government. So I finally would like to close this communication by saying to you that Indonesia is a big population, market economic growth is a very attractive place for implementing high quality trial, especially in the future. And since 2001, significant research activities towards drug development has been growing well in Indonesia. And you can see here that there are research supporting factors such as ethics committee, investigators, hospitals, CROs, labs, regulation, and insurance are available at the present time. So I would like to thank you for your kind attention. And with this, I end up my talk again. Thank you very much.